Hello, this is Lazarus at Telecom Tech, where telecom and networking technologies are simply explained. Today, we'll be simply explaining virtual eXtensible LAN, or VXLAN. If you like my content so far and you're interested in seeing more technologies like VXLAN simply explained, then please subscribe to the channel now. If you like this video, make sure to click that thumbs up button. In order to more fully understand VXLAN and how it works, it will be helpful to first understand why VXLAN is needed. What problems does VXLAN solve? And under what circumstances does it make sense to deploy VXLAN? Well, VXLAN solves some of the scalability issues that are involved with layer 2 infrastructures. Now, what do I mean? Virtually all networks, large and small, are subdivided into virtual LANs or VLANs. These are layer 2 subdivisions of networks into segments. Each VLAN will typically be assigned its own IP address subnet. Now, these subdivisions are useful in enterprise networks because they're part of the fundamental network design and architecture. You can subdivide a network based on function, department, physical location, and many other factors. Now, VLANs are identified within a network using their VLAN ID. This VLAN ID is defined as part of the IEEE 802.1Q standard for Ethernet. Now, if you're just learning about VXLAN now, it's likely that you already have a good understanding of VLANs. And if so, you will understand the significance of this diagram here, which shows an Ethernet frame with the 802.1Q VLAN tag shown. Now, I won't go into detail here concerning how the VLAN ID works within that framework, but what I will say is that this VLAN ID is defined as a 12-bit number. So you can assign up to just over 4,000 unique VLANs in a network. Now that's quite a few VLANs, even for the largest enterprise networks. For example, I'm the network administrator of the local municipality where I live, which has about 1,000 employees scattered across about 20 buildings throughout the city. And these are interconnected with a municipal fiber optic network. Now for such a network, we have close to 400 VLANs defined. So for enterprise networks, unless you're a really huge organization with tens of thousands of employees and hundreds of buildings, a 12-bit VLAN ID should be okay for most of your needs. The problem, however, arises when we apply VLANs to cloud infrastructures and large data centers. Now, with the advent of cloud computing, the deployment of countless virtual machines, and with the rise of huge centralized data centers like those from Amazon, Google, and Microsoft, the demand for more VLANs has increased. Cloud services may have tens of thousands of customers each, and each one may use several layer 2 segments. Data centers with rows upon rows of racks will need huge numbers of VLANs to ensure proper network segmentation. So 4,000 VLANs won't cut it anymore. We need a solution that will be able to deliver hundreds of thousands, and in some cases, millions of layer 2 segments. VXLAN does just that. Now, this is the primary reason for the use of VXLANs, the limitation of the number of VLANs that more traditional Ethernet provides. However, there are a couple of other vital benefits that VXLAN offers as well. Now, classic layer 2 operation of switches requires the use of some type of spanning tree protocol. This is a protocol that ensures that a layer 2 topology will not create any layer 2 loops, resulting in broadcast storms that can cause a whole network to go down. Now, STP algorithms will detect layer 2 loops, like the one shown in this diagram here, and will dynamically block appropriate interfaces on the appropriate switches, resulting in the elimination of such loops. This is vital for a network to function. However, there are some disadvantages. Let's say that this link here is blocked by the STP protocol that's running on this topology. When it's blocked, this link will actually remain idle for the duration of normal operation. It'll only be activated in the event that we have a failure in a link, such as this one. Now, this may not matter so much in small to medium-sized businesses, but as the scale of the network increases, the number of idle links increases. Now, let's take that to the extreme, where in cloud deployments and large data centers, you have hundreds or thousands of links with speeds of 10, 40, or 100 gigabits per second each. Now, imagine a large percentage of those links just sitting idle. That would be a huge waste of potential bandwidth and thus a huge waste of money. Remember, cloud deployments and data centers are all about the efficient use of network resources, and the operation of spanning tree in such an infrastructure is extremely inefficient. So the use of VXLAN also solves the inefficiencies that are introduced by spanning tree, and it ensures that no links remain idle. Now, the third and final major scalability issue that VXLAN resolves has to do with MAC address table sizes. In virtualized environments, you may run hundreds of servers or containers within a single physical server. This means that your switches serving that physical server will have to learn hundreds of MAC addresses and will have to populate their MAC address tables accordingly. Now, if you have many such physical servers connected to a single switch, just like in this topology here, then the switch will have to learn many MAC addresses on a single switch port. Now, add multiple racks with a top-of-rack switch on each one, and you can immediately see how this can result in the accumulation of an enormous number of MAC addresses in the MAC address tables of each one of those switches. And it is likely, due to that large number of virtual devices, that the MAC addresses being exchanged will very quickly overwhelm the capacity of the switch's memory. So VXLAN comes to resolve this scalability issue as well, concerning MAC address learning and MAC address table sizes. So these are the major issues that VXLAN comes to resolve. But what is VXLAN? What does it look like? Well, VXLAN is a network virtualization technology used to extend layer 2 networks over layer 3 networks. This virtualized layer 2 network infrastructure overcomes all of these scalability issues involved with more traditional layer 2 infrastructure. At the very heart of VXLAN is the concept of an overlay and an underlay network. Now, VXLAN essentially creates an overlay network by encapsulating Ethernet frames within UDP packets. This allows the creation of virtual layer 2 networks over a layer 3 underlay network. The underlay network is straightforward. Its sole function is to transfer packets from point A to point B. It operates exclusively at layer 3 without any layer 2 involvement. And by using layer 3, we can implement an IGP like OSPF or EIGRP so we can distribute traffic across that whole infrastructure. Now, the overlay and underlay networks essentially operate independently. The overlay network is virtual and it depends on the underlay network, but modifications in the overlay network do not impact the underlay network. You can add or remove links in the underlay network as long as your routing protocol can reach the destination. That way, the overlay network will remain unaffected. So by doing so, VXLAN essentially provides the flexibility to span virtual networks across different physical locations, making it easier to manage and move virtual machines without being constrained by the physical network topology. Like many network protocols, VXLAN was born out of necessity, out of the need to overcome the scalability issues involved with more traditional layer 2 infrastructures. This is the first video in a series of videos that will be covering VXLAN technology. The technology is actually an open standard and it's described in RFC 7342, to which I have a link in the description below. Stay tuned for more videos as we go more in depth to further understand VXLAN and how it works. I hope you found this video useful, and if you have, please click that thumbs up button. If you'd like me to address other related topics, feel free to let me know in the comments below. And please subscribe to get updates to newly published videos. I'm Lazarus at Telecom Tech. I hope this has been helpful for you, and I'd like to thank you for watching.